Welcome back. If you're just joining us, we'll bring you up to speed with a recap of our top stories. Here's Stephanie Zaida with the very latest.
Thank you so much, Brian. I appreciate it. Well, after a dramatic day of unexpected twists and turns, the U.S. House of Representatives has passed the Senate compromise bill to avert the so-called fiscal cliff. The Republican-controlled House passed the emergency legislation after much debate on New Year's Day. It prevents deep spending cuts and even bigger tax hikes from taking effect. The bill, considered a partial fix, was passed by the Democratic-controlled Senate earlier on Tuesday. Under the plan, taxes will rise on household incomes over $450,000. Well, President Obama has welcomed the last-minute reprieve from the fiscal cliff and has promised to sign the new legislation into law. Obama spoke just moments after the House voted 257 to 167 to approve a compromise bill hammered out between Senate leaders and Vice President Joe Biden to avert this fiscal cliff. The president welcomed the last-minute action by Congress before financial markets reopen after the New Year's Day holiday. Well, seven people have been shot dead in northern Pakistan. The victims were teachers and health aides working on a program to immunize children against polio. Their murders have caused the Pakistani government to suspend the vaccinations program, dealing a major setback in quest for a polio-free world. And those are some of your top stories for this Wednesday, January 2nd, 2013. Hard to believe it's already 2013.
I know, the year's passed by so fast.
Yeah, I don't know how long it'll take me to get used to that. So.
Thanks, Stephanie.
Thank you.